Hey, hey, how's everyone doing? Got another episode today just for you guys. Just for you guys. We're going to be, it's a celebration episode. We're actually talking to one of the mentees that I've been working with over the last, about 6 months? Student doctor department? Yeah, about 6 months. And as you guys are aware, January is a great time for a lot of new dentists that are either students or future students going into dental school, getting dental school admittance information, but also for those that are in dental school that are graduating and getting ready to move on and with their careers into residency. So actually, this segment today, I've asked Dr. Darwin, is a follow-up segment on how to get into dental school, some success strategies. And today I've got on the line future student dentist, student doctor Kwame, who's got some good news, and he's going to share with us a little bit about his travel, his process, his navigation of applying to dental school. So, future student doctor, how you doing?
I'm well. Dr. Hayes, thank you very much. First, I definitely want to just say thank you for, you know, all your direction that you've given me in the process of getting to this point. I know this is just the beginning, but you know, I'm very grateful for how far you've aided me in this process. Honestly, at this point, it doesn't even necessarily feel real, but that feeling and excitement of getting that letter, you know, of acceptance was serious. It really started off with me not necessarily knowing what direction to take. You know, my first step was definitely seeking somebody out that could kind of guide me in that. I kind of, you know, bumped into you, and you were really eager to help me out.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Let's talk about that. So we kind of met each other. I think it was on social media. Put out some information of my own passion and my own desire of helping new dentists or trying to help as many new dentists as possible. Had posted some things on, I don't know if it was Instagram or Twitter. And before you knew it, we connected. I think that's about right, right?
Yeah.
And we connected and you had mentioned that you were applying to dental school. Again, I think you saw one of my posts and we were talking about some strategies. And at the time, I was helping another colleague of yours that was in the same position who was applying to dental school. He was probably about a year behind you as far as process-wise. But nonetheless, we connected and we've been staying in contact probably these last 6 months, just kind of really mapping out some strategies, some things that I thought would be very, very helpful for you. And so tell us a little bit about your background a little bit, and then let's talk about the schools you applied to, and we'll continue.
Okay. So I started off, as an undergrad at Rutgers University, Newark. I didn't do too well. My GPA wasn't that great. I ended up going into a master's program, a biomedical science master's program. Before then, I had taken my DATs. I didn't really like the score that much. And, you know, but I still, you know, kind of shot my shot and applied to some schools. I only applied to 3 schools. That was my first mistake. I applied to Tufts, Rutgers, and Howard. I got denied by all of them. And, you know, I had to see where I went wrong. It wasn't only just my grades. It was my lack of ability to really, you know, stay in contact with those that were in the admissions offices and really reaching out to people and things like that. I kind of sat back and just waited for everything to happen. This time around, I had studied for my DATs for a good 3 months. I used DAT Destroyer. I used chat videos and things like that to really get my DAT score up. Some of my scores jumped up by about like 3 points, or even like 3 points, 4 points, and so I had a pretty good DAT score. I ended up with a 19, which is average overall, but in some sections that they really care about, such as ortho and chemistry, I got 20 and 21, and then reading comprehension, I also got a 20. So that was really important to see. Then I applied for a couple. I applied to a lot more schools this time around. I applied to about 8 schools. I applied to Howard. I applied to NYU. I applied to University of Maryland. I applied to Rutgers. I also applied to Tufts, Meharry. Where else did I apply? I tried to shoot to apply to Boston University, but that hadn't worked out for me. I can't really remember. And Touro, and I applied to Touro as
Touro,
well.
Yeah, Touro, the new college in New York. That's right.
Right.
So after we met and after we kind of connected, what were some of the things that you felt were the most helpful? Because even when we talked, you were still, you were still part of that application process. So right. What exactly do you think, looking back now, was helpful and as it relates to what you were doing or maybe not doing?
All right. So I think that honestly, without the advice that I was given by you, there's no way I would have gotten to this point. And that being the hustle mentality that I kind of gathered from the information you were giving me, I think one of the most important things was, you know,
hustle.
Being able
to, hustle, right?
Yeah, hustle mentality.
Okay.
One of the biggest things that you really, you know, showed me was that, you know, you can't just show through paper how badly you want to go to that school. You have to really reach out to them and get to know you, because one thing that you said that stuck in me is nobody knows you. And it was true. Nobody knew who I was. You know what I'm saying? Nobody knew who I was. So there was no way that they were going to look at me beyond, you know, any other applicant. Like, what really made me different?
Right.
And at the end of the day, there's so many people applying to school. So what's setting you apart? You know, like, they can't look at their application and say, oh, I know that this is the number one choice. You know, your personal statement doesn't indicate a specific school you want to go to. So they don't know how badly you want to go to that school. So you really talking, like,
right.
It really makes they know, like, yo, you are a school that I want to be at. You know,
right.
You're not just slapped onto my application.
Right, so you definitely feel like after we kind of met and we kind of talked and that you, like, your mindset changed a little bit, like your approach.
My mindset changed completely. It made me understand a different dynamic of how this all works. You know, it's different when you, like, people going through school, like, you're conditioned to feel like, all right, it's test grades, like this, you know, that, and third. Although those things are important, your personality and what you're willing to do to get to where you want to go, legally, of course, is extremely important. Like, whatever, what choices you make and how active you are in trying to, you know, make your goals become a reality is very important.
Yeah.
And that's something that you taught me, that I may have knew, but you brought that to the forefront. You made that known and apparent. And so, like, applying that to the field in itself, like, all right, well, I need to connect with those people that are going to be the ones making the decision if I'm going or not.
Right,
you know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, because lots of times, it's, you know, again, it's not what you know, but who you know. So I know one of the strategies that I shared with you was, you know, making sure that if you have contacts at a particular school,
right,
that you maximize that contact and don't be reasonable. I know, we kind of said, hey, if you know somebody at the school, you need to contact them. Say, hey, I want to come. I'm still very interested in your school.
Right.
I want to come in for an interview. You know, who do I need to get my information to and to kind of get my paperwork in front of them? And I think that was the case for at least two of the schools.
Yeah.
Right? I think we called NYU, we called Howard, we got a contact with somebody at Maryland, and also at BU, a place that you hadn't even applied to, but because
right.
I knew somebody there,
yeah,
I passed that on to you.
Opportunity, exactly. And also, I think, like, what the craziest part about it is, you know, getting accepted first, I got accepted, you know, into Howard, but getting accepted there was really kind of wild, because at first they were like, no, you know what I'm saying? They said no.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about that. They said no first time.
Yeah, they said no. And the You were like, no. You're like, it doesn't matter what they said. Did you get a rejection letter? No, it doesn't matter what they said. People, I was curious. You're like, did you get a rejection letter? I said, no. They're like, then it doesn't matter. There's always a way. You know what I'm saying? You're like, right. If you try 10 ways, maybe one's going to work. You know, and it sounds like some people may view it as a waste of time, but then that means you didn't want it that bad.
There you go. So
clearly, like, I had to do everything in my power. And so, you know, I was contacting them saying, you know, I know that you fill up a class, like this, that, and the third. I really want to go here. And I told them the reasons why I want to go there. I was contacting admissions. I was calling at least like every other day, trying to get in contact with somebody. And I didn't even necessarily get an email back. I just got an invitation. You know, like I got an invitation for an interview. And for me, like that was enough. You know, that was like the light. The light just opened that tunnel.
Yeah, so you're saying you just continue to kind of hustle. And kind of explain that process, like what happened, what was the turning point, do you think, for one or two of those schools, and kind of describe to us, like, what happened, like, how did it go down from the time you contacted them to what you did to you, what, you know, just that whole process, kind of share that with me.
So for me, like, I realized, like, the most important part is you try to maximize as many contacts as possible, which is also something that you told me. So, like, what I did was I contacted people, students, you know, maybe you could get me in contact with somebody that's a faculty member or somebody that knows anybody that may be part of the admissions or anything like that, like anything even remotely close to that. And I would contact them and, you know, say, hey, you know, I'm really interested in the school, this, that, and the third. They'll say, all right, forward me some of your credentials. You know, some people didn't get back to me. Some people did get back to me. They're like, all right, this looks okay, but you need, you're missing this class, so it's looking kind of shaky, you know, you're missing this class. And so I kept hearing that. And, you know, because I kept hearing that, I was like, you know, you told me that was discouraging me, but you told me, you know, a lot of schools will accept you upon a contingency. You know, if they want to, they'll accept you upon a contingency.
That's right, on a contingency. That's right. That's right. Mm-hmm.
That was something I actually didn't know. So, you know, that of course, got me more motivated. So I was contacting them saying, hey, you know, I proposed it myself. I said, hey, upon a contingency, would it be possible for me to get accepted into the school, you know, upon this contingency? And it's not like I had a lot going on. It was one class. It was the part two of anatomy and physiology, which the first part I got an A, so it clearly looked as if, you know, that would be promising for me.
Right.
So I was contacting them, even though I was calling the office a lot, there wasn't much of a response, but I was emailing, I went on the website, like you told me as well, and emailing those that were part of the admissions, emailing them, letting them know I really wanted to come. I'm not sure if somebody opened my email. I'm sure one of them had to because it was a no before, you know? So somebody had to have opened my email. It was really just a waiting game, and a waiting game, but not waiting doing nothing. It was waiting being consistent with reaching out. And so right. I was just reaching out on a consistent basis, calling, emailing, and, you know, eventually I was able to receive an interview. Wow. And then, you know, just like you told me prior to, you're like, you know, by going through an interview, you've got to look up information on the school. You've got to keep up to date on, you know, what it is that they do, what they're known for, what is the, you know, the importance of, like, what they focus on, history, organization. Just know as much about the school as possible. And then I took that and, you know, attributed those things that I learned to myself and how I would be a good fit for that.
So you basically got an interview. You eventually, through all your perseverance and determination and calling right. and contacting, you got an interview at Howard, and they right. brought you in. But right before you went, you did some homework, and it sounds like you either went on the internet, but you I think you went a little bit deeper. You went into student doctor. You said you went into student right. doctor and kind of right. got some information based on right. some other postings and what people had said about Howard, right. and you said you took that information and then kind of applied it to yourself so that you would right. be able to be prepared for the interview. So how did the interview go?
The interview was really cool. I mean, honestly, at first, I wasn't as psyched just because it was my first interview, but, you know, quickly I became more, you know, relaxed because the atmosphere was really cool. Like, the atmosphere was really cool. I was able to, you know, I sat down, there was 9 other people coming there to interview, and we were all conversing. Talking, it was a really relaxed atmosphere.
Right.
So that kind of caught me. And then the admissions, it wasn't like it was an interrogation. The interview itself was more of a conversation, you know? So that conversation incorporated various questions that some of them I looked up and found, and some of the questions I didn't see. But they all came naturally to me because I understood the view of the school, what the school looks for and what they want. So, like, I was able to really answer the questions accordingly. And, of course, like, what surprised me the most was, you know, the interview wasn't just to see how you would be at the school, but how the school would be for you. Because, obviously, if you're at the interview, they want to see you in person to see
right.
if you would be a good. And then they also want you to go there at that point that they want you. So they're going to tell you things about the school as well. So I didn't, like, those were things that those were, like, dynamics that I didn't really think I was going to encounter. But it was really, really cool. It was cool.
So you had an interview. They I think they said they get back to you in a week or something. And then what happened?
Yeah.
And then what happened?
Okay, so when they told me they would get back to me, I was like, all right, well, you know, we'll see how this goes. You know, I felt like I did pretty well at the interview. You know, so I just went back, and then the first thing I did was send out thank yous. You know, as per what you told me as well, just sending out thank yous, appreciating them for, you know, inviting me out, because I really did feel honored to be interviewed by them. So, you know, I sent that out, and then I was just, you know, got responses back, you know, positive responses saying they really appreciated that. And then I eventually waited. I waited it out. I think it was Wednesday. Wednesday around 4 p.m. I received a letter of acceptance. It showed up on my phone because I definitely starred any email coming from Howard. And, you know, it showed up on my phone. Nice big ringtone. I saw the acceptance. And I didn't even open the letter yet. I just started jumping. Like, I was so, you know, I was elated. It was an awesome feeling. You know, it was great. And
yeah.
At that point, I was like, I have to, you know, I called my mother and I called you, like, I mean, yeah, I called you, reached out to you to let you know. And, you know, like, now we're at this point.
Right, right. So that's good. So the end product was you got an acceptance to dental school, and you are now officially part of the class of 2021 for dental school.
Absolutely.
Oh, man, that's, and it doesn't hurt that it's it was one of your top 3 schools, so that doesn't hurt either, right?
Not at all.
That's great, man. I'm so proud of you. I'm glad you took heed to some of the things that I thought would be helpful, and you know, I commend you for doing the work, because it's, you know, sometimes the easiest things to do are the easiest things not to do too. You know. So I'm just so proud of you, very happy for you. And in closing, I just wanted to ask you, if you had one piece of advice, knowing what you know now, what you've done through this process, and actually this is the second year, right? This is your second year that you actually applied, correct?
Yeah.
Knowing what you know now, and with a conglomeration of all the experience and processes and things that you've done, if there's one thing, one or two things, well, just one thing, if there's one thing that you could share with other colleagues or other students that are applying to dental school and about the process and what they should do or whatever, what would be one piece of advice that you would want to share with them?
I would definitely say, do not take no for an answer. Like, no, no doesn't mean no. No, you know what I'm saying? No doesn't mean no in this process. You know, when you get that official letter of rejection, like, if I'm going down, I'm going down swinging. Like, that's really how I view the situation. You know, and you might just land something. Like, you just might land something. Like, do not take no for an answer.
Don't take no for an answer.
Put yourself, regardless of what people say around you, I know even when I was applying, some admissions felt like they're like, you know, I don't think you should apply this cycle. I think you shouldn't apply this cycle. I heard that a couple times. Wow. You know, I heard, you know, it's very unlikely that you may get into school. But as I was reaching out to schools and actually talking to them, they were more than happy to hear from me. You know, they were more than happy to hear from me, and they were satisfied with my credentials. So if I had listened to people that I may have viewed as, you know, supporters, or I took them more seriously, I may not be hearing.
Wow. So there you go, guys. There you go. No, do not take no for an answer. No just means no right now, but it doesn't mean no tomorrow, because, you know, things may change. Situations may come up that you may be the best candidate tomorrow, but maybe not today, but tomorrow's another day. Hey, man, thanks so much for sharing. I know you were busy, and we've been trying to link up, but I'm so glad that you were able to share this success story. And I'm this end product that we got here, which is a dental school acceptance. Hey, man, you're on your way, brother. You're on your way.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hayes. I mean, I couldn't have done it without you. I really appreciate you. I really do.
Hey, man, no problem. I'm so proud of you. I'm glad it all worked out. And just got to finish strong with your classes and just get ready for four more years of some hard work, but it'll pay off, man. Hey, if I can do it, and I was an architect major, man, please. If I can do it, hey, you can do it, and you will do it. So I'm glad that we're able to connect. I'm here for you each and every step of the way. If you have questions about, you know, things that are in school that you're working on, hey, that's what I'm here for you and all these other new dentists that are out here. Again, that's part of my goal and part of my purpose, trying to help as many new dentists as possible, whether you're applying to dental school, whether you're in school, or whether you're getting out of school, getting ready to transition into private practice or to residency. My goal is to try to help you as much as possible. So future student Dr. Kwame, thanks so much for sharing this amazing story. And we'll, you know, I think we should start journaling your 4 years, man. That might be a nice little documentary type of thing for you to kind of journey your process, or journal your journey or your process through dental school. That might be something to think about.
That would be awesome.
Yeah, man. Hey, thanks so much. I'll talk to you soon, okay?
Most definitely. You take care.
Okay. Thanks.
All right.
So there you go. Oh, man, I'm so happy. Success story. No does not mean no. No means no right now, but tomorrow may mean yes. All right? I think that's the take-home message here. No means no right now, but not tomorrow. So, again, anytime you guys have questions about dental school, about applying to dental school, about your time during dental school, applying to residencies, or we're getting ready to get into the workforce. Hey, if I can be of some resource or some help, contact me at newdentistcoach@gmail.com, newdentistcoach@gmail.com. I also can be reached on Twitter, which is Twitter and Instagram, Smile Dr. Darwin. Snapchat also, Smile Dr. Darwin. If you have questions, comments, I have a couple people I'm still working with, and my goal is to have this same type of success story, to get you into dental school, get you that job that you want, get to that salary that you want, get you that residency, that specialty program that you want, whatever that is. Yo, I'm trying to help you. Help me help you. Thanks so much for joining me, and talk to you soon.